Welcome to ESPRIT's latest tips and tricks video. Today I'm going to show you how to add collet chucks for simulation in ESPRIT 2021. There are two techniques that can be used for both Miltern and Swiss style machines. One is adding SDL models to the machine setup. The other is adding fixtures to the simulation parameters. Adding collet chucks as fixtures is the easier of the two techniques. The collet and chuck could be imported as a single model or created in the ESPRIT document with geometry and revolved into a solid. This technique is widely used to simulate guide bushings for Swiss machines. When the collet chucks are added to the machine setup, different collet sizes can be changed easily. The collet will also have an open and close motion, which can be useful during part transfers. The machine setups can be saved and opened in different documents or included in templates. All chuck models should be imported with the XYZ work plane active. When adding chucks for machine setup STL files, the models must be oriented in the machine coordinate system where the center line of the chuck is on the Z-axis. When adding chucks for fixtures in the simulation parameters, the models must be oriented to the part coordinate system where the center line of the chuck is on the X-axis. For the main spindle, a collet chuck will be added to the simulation as a fixture. Notice how the model is translated away from the backside of the part. We need to make sure the distance from the spindle face to the program zero matches our machine setup. This can be done using the Solids tab in the Project Manager. After selecting the face, open the machine setup and compare the values between the machine origin Z and the face center X in the Project Manager. We use this value because the fixture center line is on the X axis. With these values matching, the face of the chuck will be mated against the spindle face in the simulation. Open the simulation parameters and navigate to the Solids tab. Here we will add the solid models as fixtures for our simulation. Change the type to fixture and create from to solid. We can change the colors for each fixture. Click the arrow and select the solid. Finally, click the add button so the model is added to the simulation. Repeat these steps for all solids. To complete the main spindle for simulation, we need to open the machine setup and select the main spindle. Change the chuck type to custom OD. This will turn off the standard chuck and use our new fixtures instead. We can now run the simulation and see our results. Now that our main spindle is set up, we can move on to the subspindle. For the subspindle, we need models for both the chuck and collet. These models will be saved as STL files. The orientation is very important. The origin of the chuck must be on the face where it mounts to the spindle with the Z-axis pointing away from the face. Only one section of the collet is needed and all other features behind the chuck face can be removed. This single section will be used to replace all jaws in the machine setup. Notice the location of the collet. It is shifted so that the radius is on the Z-axis line. The machine setup uses the X-axis for the jaw clamping motion. The collet section must be centered on this axis. Once the models are located properly, we can save them as STL files. To do this, select the chuck model, then go to File and select Save As. Change the file type to STL and add a file name. Repeat the same steps to save the collet as an STL file. Now we need to modify our machine setup. Let's start with the chuck. I'll measure the length of the chuck using the Solids tab. Select the front face of the chuck. Copy the center Z length from the Project Manager. This value is used because the center line of the chuck is on the global Z axis. There are two locations where we will place this value. The first is the STL reference point. This will be a negative value to move the control point from the spindle face to the face of the chuck. The second place is in the geometry for the chuck length. This is a positive value from the face of the chuck to the spindle face. Next, we need to change the home position. For this machine, the distance between centers is just over 41 inches. We need to subtract the chuck length from the distance between centers. The new value will be placed in the Z home position. Now we need to add the collet length to the machine setup. Select the chuck geometry. The collet length in this setup is just under 3/8 of an inch. You can get this value by measuring from the chuck face to the face of the collet. Update the jaw length with the new value. Since the clamping radius for this collet is 5 millimeters, or 0.197 inches, I will set the jaw radial distance to 0.172 inches so the collet can close on a diameter smaller than 10 millimeters, and the open distance to 0.05 inches. Now the collet will be able to open and release the part. Click OK, and then change the chuck type to custom OD. The STL models must now be added to the machine setup. Select the subspindle, then new solid. Change the name and colors as needed. Next, select the STL file. Then embed the file so it stays in the simulation. For the chuck, we need to set the location to spindle base. Repeat the same steps for the collet. Set the location for the collet to all jaws. After the STL files are added to the machine setup, click OK and simulate the results. That's today's ESPRIT tips and tricks video. We hope that you enjoyed it. Don't forget to visit our website at espritcam.com and to subscribe to our newsletter for more cool videos. Stay tuned for other ESPRIT tips and tricks.